guys, it's Jessica from Peace Out Books, and today I'm here with a book haul for you. I have a lot of books I got recently, so I want to share them with you. I also got some new shirts from Hello Lovely. There's a sweatshirt. It says Historical Romance Book Club, and then it says Rakes, Dukes, and Scoundrels at the end, and I really love this. I also got a couple shirts that Becca sent me. So this was sent to me. I am a rep for them. Use my code PEACE15 down below if you want to save on anything in their shop, 15%. But they also sent me this one where it says, I like long walks on the promenade and getting caught in the garden with the Duke. I love that. And then my favorite is this one. Let me take the sticker off real quick. It says, Viscount me in for another episode, and it's adorable. I love it, and it's for Bridgerton, really, and it's adorable because Anthony gets season 2. Anthony's a Viscount, so I'm excited to have these. Like I said, use my code down below, and I'll get to the books. So the first few I'm going to talk about are all from the publisher. That the first one sent to me is A Lady's Formula for Love by Elizabeth Everett. This is actually a historical romance in the trade paperback size with the illustrated cover. This one, she is a scientist and she's working for the crown, and he is a protection officer. I don't know if he's like assigned to her or something, but it says he spends a lot of time in her company and the club members' company because she founds a clandestine sanctuary for female scientists. So it sounds really fun. I don't think I've read about a female scientist historical romance, so hopefully I enjoy this. The next four are like super exciting books. So the first one is An Unexpected Earl by Anna Harrington. I actually started my first Anna Harrington on audio and I'm obsessed with the story. So in this one, it's a second chance romance. 12 years ago, they were in love and now he's the Earl and he's trying to stop this criminal group that's threatening the lives of people, and her brother is kidnapped by that group. So they need to work together, I think, to get her brother back. And it's the new size. It's floppy. I really love it. I always show this compared to this. It's like, that's the size of the new mass markets now. This one's from Sourcebooks, so they're bringing those out. Another one in that size is The Duke Heist by Erica Ridley. This one, the author sent it to me with a cute little note and some stickers that just fell out. And I'm very excited to have this. So thank you to the author for sending it my way. This is published through Forever. And in this one, I know she's trying to uncover a missing painting that her adoptive father wants the children he adopted to get. And she ends up kidnapping a Duke instead. It sounds really fun. I'm going to start it this week. So I might have finished it by the time this video goes up. We shall see. The next one I got is Jackson by Laquette. And this one, she wants to turn the ranch that her family has had into a place of rest and healing. But then she is being driven away by someone who's, I think, trying to hurt her. And the hero is a ranger. And I think he helps protect her. And they fall in love. It sounds really good. I'm really excited for this one. Then I was sent a copy of The Heiress Gets a Duke by Harper St. George. And this one, I really do love that cover. She is an American heiress and people say that she is not a respectable match, and so her parents then decide to auction her younger sister off to the highest bidder, and I think she ends up getting married to the person that is supposed to get her sister, I think. I don't know. I'm excited for this. Then I was sent Reckless Road by Christine Feehan. This is the fourth or fifth book in the series, and I have not started it yet, but I really want to, and so I'm happy that I was sent this. Trying to look and see how many there are. I think there are 5, yes. And I think I own all of them, and I've been meaning to read the series, so I have to get to it. But the fifth book recently came out. And then I was sent a huge stack from St. Martin Press. I'm not going to go through all of them, what they're about. I'll just show you the titles because they just sent me a big box, and I've only heard of 2 of them. So the first one is, I don't even know what, I think this is called just Boone. The title's right here, super small, by Emily March. It is The Eternity Springs, The McBrides of Texas. But there's a cute dog there, and my mom would probably really want to read this if there's a dog on the cover. But then I got a cowboy romance, which is Secret Nights with a Cowboy by Caitlin Cruz. It just says cowboys don't kiss and tell on the cover. The one I'm really excited about, though, is The Princess and the Rogue by Kate Bateman. This is the third book in her series. I absolutely loved book one, so I'm excited to have book 3. I need to get to book 2. I do own that one, and I've been meaning to read it. My libraries don't have the audiobook, so I need to pick it up physically and then get to book 3. Then I was sent 10 Rules for Faking It by Sophie Sullivan, and this one's cover is really cool. It is Truth, Lies, and Second Dates by Mary Janice Davidson. That looks like a lot of fun. And then Stroke of Luck by Opal Carew. I used to get her books like when I first started blogging. And then Meet Me in Bombay by Jenny Ashcroft. So this whole thing, big box, came for me from St. Martin's Press. So I have all of these. Then this sounds adorable. I was sent Much Ado About You by Samantha Young. And this one, I'm so excited for. She's 33, she's passed over for a promotion, so she ends up getting a holiday plan in a quaint English village, and the package comes with a temporary position at a bookstore that's right beneath the rental apartment. So she falls for one of the villagers, giving me the holiday vibes, and I'm very excited to read this. Then I was sent a copy of The X Talk by Rachel Lynn Solomon. I've heard amazing things about this. It kind of matches my outfit right now. But the main character is a producer, and she has a new colleague, and they despise each other, and they pitch a concept where there are exes talking about their struggles on air, and the boss decides they should pretend to be exes and do the whole show themselves, and they don't like lying to their listeners, but they decide to do it so they don't get fired. And so that sounds fun. I'm excited to read it. I don't think I've read any like radio romances, so this sounds fun. Then I was sent a copy of The Kindest Lie by Nancy Johnson. This one, our main character is currently, she's married and he wants to start a family, but she still is not over her past and how she had a child previously and was forced to give it up. And so she decides to go home. And I think this is more of like a literary fiction family drama, and she uncovers things about her past and her family. And that's what this is about. It sounds very good. And I'm very intrigued, so I'm excited to read this. Then in my Mystic Box, which is a dark romance box, I got the Boston Underworld collection by A. Zavarelli. There are two books in here, and it is hardback, and then I did get this copy of Hate Crush by A. Zavarelli. So both of these came with a little photo booklet as well. I will leave my link to the unboxing down below if you want to see that, and my code if you want to save on your own. And then I was sent One of the Good Ones by Micah Moulay and Maritza Moulay. And this one, first of all, I really love this cover, and I've seen really good things about this already. It is about a teen social activist who ends up being killed under mysterious circumstances after attending a social justice rally. So her sister and their family end up trying to question what happened and figure out what happened to her. And then the sisters end up going on a journey to honor their sister. I'm very excited to read this. This was also sent to me with Roman and Jewel, which I have my physical copy of at school. This one, they are actors in a play, and she is the understudy, but then like the video comes out of them practicing, her as the understudy and the male lead, and people want her to start to be the lead, and there's a romance as well. So I'm very excited for these two. Then somehow, I don't know how this author got my address, but I was sent Holiday With You by Claudia Bergoa and Graham Clare. I don't know, it's just a holiday romance. Then my amazing mother got me Clanlands for Christmas, and this took over a month to come because it was backordered from The Poison Pen, which is Diana Gabaldon's indie bookstore, and so it did come signed by Diana Gabaldon, the foreword, and then it came with a book plate from Graham and Sam Hewen, and this one is just their book about going around Scotland. I love Scotland, so I'm very, very excited to have this. Then in my Hello Lovely box, I was sent Man in Charge by Laura Lynn Page, and then Chasing the Moon by SM Soto. These are exclusive covers to the box, so I'll link my unboxing down below in my code for Hello Lovely, which I've already talked about because I have my shirt from them. Then I was sent Like You Love Me by Adrienne Locke. She has a bed and breakfast in Tennessee, and her childhood best friend needs to prove to his prospective employer that he's a committed man, so they decide to get married, and he'll take care of her bills if she agrees to a temporary marriage of convenience. That sounds like a lot of fun, and I'm excited for that. Okay, this one sounds interesting. So it is The Infinity Chords by Akemi Don Bowman, and in this one, everything's going well for her. She's trying to like get together with the boy she really likes, and then she's killed, and she wakes up in infinity, which is where human consciousness goes when physical bodies die. So, very interesting premise. I'm excited to get to that. The next one I was sent is this gorgeous, gorgeous cover, and it is Wings of Ebony by J.L. And this is about Rue, and her mom's is murdered, and she's snatched away by a father who abandoned her at birth, and she's going to his home called Gizon, which is a secret country of gods who wield a powerful magic. So, and it says there her existence a crime because she's half god, half human. So, very interesting. I'm really excited to read this, though, because it's just stunning. And that premise sounds really cool, so I'm excited. The rest are historical romances, so I'm just going to go through them, and then we'll be done. So, I got a Shirley Busby lot on eBay. So, I got Deceive Not My Heart, and The Tiger Lily, which is very pretty, and Whisper to Me of Love, or Whisper Me of Love. I really, really like that step back. And then Love a Dark Rider with this step back. Then Megan from Books and Boops showed me these and I bought them from her, and they are these four. She has an Instagram and an eBay. I'll link her down below. So I got Duke of Sin by Elizabeth Hoyt, and I'm trying to collect all of Elizabeth Hoyt's books. Then Notorious Pleasures with that one. This is a pirate romance, so I'm really excited for this. And then A Rose in Winter by Kathleen Woodwiss, and The Highlander by Lane Kaufman, who I'm also trying to collect from, and I really love that step back of hers. Then I got some from Thrift Books. So I got Dancing at Midnight by Julia Quinn. I have books 1 and 3, so I wanted book 2 in case I decided to read the series. And then I have When the Duke Was Wicked, which I read and loved, by Lorraine Heath. And I really just love the yellow dress in there. And then I got the third book in the series. So I already owned book 2. And so I've only read 1 and 2, but this one is The Duke and the Lady in Red with that step back. Then I got Loved by a Warrior by Donna Fletcher. And then Beauty and the Beast by Hannah Howell. This one is like in super bad condition, but the cover is so pretty. So I'm glad I have this. I just had to be careful with that one. At Half Price Books, I picked up Delicious by Sherry Thomas with a fake step back. But this one, she is a chef, so I'm very excited to read that. I got Love Me with Fury by Connie Mason, Desert Ecstasy by Connie Mason, Creole Fires by Kat Martin, and Compromised Hearts by Hannah Howell. I really love this. I want to collect Hannah Howell's old historicals, so that's pretty. Dance of Seduction by Sabrina Jeffries. I'm also trying to collect hers with the stepbacks on the back. And then I have The Forbidden Lord by Sabrina Jeffries. These are all the ones I also bought for Megan from Books and Boops. Then she sent me this trilogy by Danielle Harmon. So we have The Defiant One, The Beloved One, and The Wicked One. I really love the cover of that one. So I'm excited to have these as well. And then I went to Half Price Books and I got The Secret Pearl because an author recommended this to me when I asked for author recommendations for their favorite romances, so this one I wanted to get. And then I got Where Dreams Begin by Lisa Kleypas. I don't own this one yet, so I'm excited to have that. This was on clearance, and it is This Rake of Mine by Elizabeth Boyle because it has this step back on the back cover. And then I got the original copy of Love is Blind by Lindsay Sands. She's not blind, but she has really bad eyesight, and her mom thinks that glasses make her look ugly, so she can never wear her glasses out, like, to balls and stuff, so she's pretty much blind. I'd be blind if I didn't wear my glasses. Then I got The Duchess in His Bed by Lorraine Heath. To Distraction by Stephanie Lawrence was on clearance, so I picked that up. And then these two I got from the Book Loft in Columbus, which is my local bookstore, indie bookstore. I ordered them on Black Friday, and they didn't get here until January, which is fine. I didn't get to them yet, so I have Dreaming of You by Lisa Kleypas, and then I also got Annie's Song by Katherine Anderson. I got these because people recommended them to me on Instagram. And the last one I have is actually sent to me from Sheila from Instagram. She accidentally got an extra copy from Amazon. I think one was lost, and then it came, and then her replacement came. So she sent me a copy of Famine by Laura Thalassa, and I'm really excited. She said she read the series because of me, so she wanted to send it to me since she had an extra one. So thank you, Sheila, for sending it to me. This is the third one in the Four Horsemen series. I'm halfway through book 2 still, and I gotta finish them, and then I'll read this one. And that is my book haul. Let me know down below if you've read any of these or what you're excited for me to read. I would love to hear. As always, thank you so much for watching, and have a good day. Bye.